Malcolm Turnbull is banking on the lure of tax cuts to dig his government out of a political hole. He's promising tax relief for what he calls the hard-working middle class, but Labor claims it's merely a distraction.
With politics serving him up lemons and no time to stop and smell the flowers, Malcolm Turnbull...
What are you selling for today?
..turns to selling tax cuts.
Our determination is to ensure that we have more dollars left in the pockets of hard-working Australians. Our focus now is on middle-income tax cuts.
No details on how big the cuts will be or how they'll be paid for while maintaining the path back to surplus, but a promise that in next year's budget, tax relief will be in the picture.
Taxes in Australia are high, there's no doubt about that.
It's like free beer tomorrow, isn't it? I mean, this bloke, he just... It just says whatever comes into his head to keep the wolves from the door.
The risk is any tax cuts means it's sayonara surplus.
Labor says the government is already raising taxes on middle-income earners by up to $400 a year by increasing the Medicare levy to pay for the NDIS. And the Malcolm Turnbull's looking for a distraction from criticism over his decision to postpone next week's House of Representatives sitting.
A desperate look-over-here attempt. Here's a shiny thing. Please don't notice that my government is falling apart before your eyes.
The government hopes this dents Labor's most potent attack on top hat Turnbull, the champion of the big end of town, who can now promise to lower taxes for big business and the little guy. As Bill Shorten and four of the five House crossbenchers write to Malcolm Turnbull demanding he reinstate next week's sittings...
..cancelling Parliament because it's all too hard. Yeah, I think that is outrageous.
Not according to ministers like Greg Hunt, who hope today's announcement...
..more money in the pocket through income tax cuts...
..stops the government's slide... ..in the polls. Mark Riley, 7 News.